All right, my friends, let's go through our first advanced query. The first query we're going to try to write here is to answer this question, or essentially do what this thing says. So for each comment, we want to show the contents of the comment, and we also want to show the username of the person who wrote the comment. And so an example of what we might see is this right here. I want to see just the contents and the username of the person who authored it. So let's take a look at a diagram and understand how we might approach this problem. Okay, so here's our database. First off, there's no mention in that question that we just saw of anything related to photos whatsoever. So we probably don't need to worry about that photos table. In addition, that little query or the question right here is mentioning two different kinds of resources, both comments and users. And I didn't see any mention inside there of anything like least or greatest or average or anything like that. So this is a join, or excuse me, this is a hint to me, kind of a sign that we might need to use that join technique that we mentioned in the last video. When we think about the relationship between these two tables right here, remember comments has a user ID column. That is a foreign key column that tells us who the author of each comment is. So in theory, if we could somehow write some SQL to take a look at each comment, extract the contents, take that user ID, and look up the related user ID in the users table, that would probably somehow solve this query. Well, let's go back over to our editor really quickly. We're just going to write out a solution for this right away, and then we'll come back and take a look at a diagram to understand what the solution does. Okay, so for this very first one, we're just going to write a solution out directly, and we'll discuss what it is doing for us. So we're going to put in here, select contents and username from comments. And then here's a part that we have not really seen before in great detail. We're going to write out join users on users.id equal to comments. Dot user underscore ID. Now double check everything you've got on line number 3 right here. Just make sure it's exactly what I have. After you double check that, we're then going to run this, and we'll see a result of something like this right here. So I see contents and username off to the right-hand side. Well, it definitely looks like this answers what we're trying to solve. It looks like this query is pretty accurate, but it doesn't really kind of help us understand what this join statement is doing. So again, let's go take a look at a diagram and try to understand what join does. Okay, I'm going to be kind of tabbing back and forth very quickly between this right here and this diagram. I apologize if it's a little bit annoying that I'm tabbing back very quickly, but I just want to refer to different things very quick. So first off, we know that we want some information from both comments and users. Again, that is a sign that we might want to use a join. Secondly, we are trying to refer to some columns or information in both tables. So we want access to contents right here and username right here. Because we are trying to access information in two different tables, again, that is a sign that we might want to use a join. So let's now focus on what that query actually does for us. First off, we start off with the from statement. From operates just like how we've seen earlier on inside the course. We could think of from as doing some initial selection of the rows that we want to somehow operate on. So in this case, we are saying take all the different rows from comments. Next thing that gets executed is the join statement. When we say join users, that means that we want to somehow combine information from the rows we already selected during from with some rows from the users table. So we want to somehow take these rows and somehow match them together with rows from users. Behind the scenes, anytime you see that join statement, you can kind of think or imagine that the following thing is happening. You can kind of imagine that our database is making a temporary copy of that initial table, in this case, comments. And then we can once again kind of imagine that this imaginary table right here gets renamed to something like comments with users. And then finally, we can also imagine that the database is then going to iterate through all these different rows and is going to try to match each of these rows together with the row from the users table using the matching statement that we put on the other side of on. So this is our matching statement. This says that for every row in the users table, take a look at the ID and match that up with the row from the comments table specifically using the value out of the user ID column. So let's walk through what really goes on with that little equals part right there. So we can imagine that our database is going to go through all these different comments. It's going to take a look at user ID. And then for every value inside of user ID, it's going to go into the users table and try to find a user with that ID right there. In this case, an ID of 3. So in this case, our database would go through users, find a user with ID 3, and then we can imagine once again that we're going to kind of copy that user and put them down into this new temporary table. Those two columns are still going to have the same meaning as what they have inside the users table. So now we have taken a row from comments and somehow matched it up with the appropriate row out of our users table. Our database is then going to repeat that same process for every row inside of comments. So next up is user of ID 4. Now our database is going to go to the users table, find a user with ID 4, here they are right here, and put them right there. Next, user with ID 2, we'd put them right there. And then finally, user with ID 1. And user with ID 1, once again. So we can imagine that's what we end up with. We now have this temporary kind of imaginary table, and we can refer to or select any of the different columns inside of here. In this case, we selected only contents and username. We didn't really care about any of the other columns inside of here. So we can imagine that all the other columns kind of fall away, and we are left with just contents and username. And that's what we see in our output result set over here. So I see contents and username. If we wanted to, we could very easily adjust that select statement and select some other columns out of this temporary table. For example, maybe photo ID. So we could try to pull out photo ID as well from the select statement. So if I now run this, I get an additional column there of photo ID. All right. So that is the join statement. Again, we want to think about join statements anytime we're referring to information between different tables. This is not the only time we're going to look at join statements in detail. For the rest of this section, we're going to be taking a look at a lot of other queries that use join statements as well, and you're going to get your own practice with them too. So if join statements are still confusing, don't sweat it. You will get lots of practice. All right, this video is running a little bit long, so let's take a quick pause right here and continue in just a moment.